He came in here with his wife. How many years, can you quickly give that brother Mike? Thank you, sister. How many years you've been struggling without child? Your wife struggled without child?
The boy is among the media. He's 13 years old now.
Can you hear that? 13 years, their child. So for 13 years, they have been struggling looking for another child, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
13 years. They were struggling looking for child. The first day when I was sitting, standing over there, he came with a woman. He said, Pastor, I can play talking drum. I can play talking drum. I said, what is talking drum? He said, okay. You can play. Can you play it here? Say yes. But my wife, we are looking for baby. Say we are looking for baby. I say here we don't look for baby because baby full everywhere. I say, well, it's okay. Your wife will have what? Baby what?
Baby boy.
I said he was looking at me as if I'm a. What was in your mind that day?
I wanted to come to church and play for the church and go back because as an instrumentalist, when there is no work, we just use it to survive. So getting to this place, the church I'm playing for is in Yobe. The knockoff at 3, I said, no, that one is long time. But when I came here, I think I'm inside the right place now. I don't even complain about the time again, but now I can tell you I'm buying car and car and car and with a baby boy.
He was the one that brought the brother. From that moment, the wife was delivered. Go, and he told me something. He said, please, I don't have money. I don't have transport to come to church because this place is far. I said, okay, I'll be giving you money every month to come, so long as you can play. But today, what happened?
The anointing is too much on me. Even in where I'm working, they say to me, it's like, Brother Jimmy, you are using something. I say, yes, I'm using something because I'm a Christian. So this brother of mine is one of Nigerian Football Supporters Club also. He's an instrumentalist. I say, where I'm doing my muti, I will take you there. That's the reason why I bring him to church. And grace to God Almighty today is getting citizen, American citizen.
And are you driving now?
I'm driving with God.
You have your own car now.
I got two cars now.
Can you hear that? Do you hear that? But the way he was attending church, they closed by 3 o'clock. Here we close, you know. You know. Thank you. No car. I was the one giving him transport. But today, he has a baby boy and he has two cars. What a God we serve. What a son we worship. He knows your name. Please be patient with him. That spirit that always tell you, no, don't stay too long. That one is responsible. Which appointment would you have besides having an appointment with your father? Huh? I know very well some of us, we are civil servants. Some of us, we are housewives. Yes. I do not do it intentionally to keep you here. Can I tell you, if I want us to close by 3, me, I want us to close. You know what time? 11 o'clock. Pray for the man of God. Pray for the man of God. Pray for me. Pray for yourself. Pray for our nations. This world we live is not a funfair. It's a battleground. When you see yourself leaving the church before we share grace, can I tell you, when you leave a church before grace, there's trouble on the way. The Father in heaven called me when I became a Christian. When he chose me, he told me, I chose you. But I want to tell you something. When you finish prayer without sharing grace, and you just walk away, your prayer of that day is incomplete. It's incomplete. Please note it down. It's incomplete. What is the grace? The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit. Rest and abide with us. The sweet fellowship. So if you don't share sweet fellowship, you are in crisis. But all of us, because we look at time, we have another appointment. Instead of having an appointment with the Father, But we will try our best to make sure we continue to ask the Father to give us the grace so that we can close on time, like today. Hallelujah. Like today. You know, if I close on time, that brother that testified, you see the how demon said he was going everywhere in the world. Demon, he was going everywhere in the world. I know that brother for 23 years. He never came to this church. I know him, this brother that testified. For how many years I know you? 22. Good. 22 years I know him. God used me to save his elder brother in Nigeria. Hallelujah. So when God wants to use you, he started using you from small. Be patient with God. This God will serve here. As long as you are here, you will never die young. Yeah. They can torment you. Look at, you listen to his testimony. After destroying the idol, there's something he didn't tell you. The pastor that was going to destroy the idol had an accident on the way and broke his arm. So he was not among the people that went there to bend the idol. But did they destroy the idol? Because the idol would have died. The idol wouldn't have followed him. The idol followed him from that time to this moment. No money to eat food. He gave somebody, how much you get for your house rent? 12,000 rands to go and pay house rent. The person eat the money. So he doesn't have a house. 12,000 rand, he asked the person, why do you spend my money? He said, I don't know. Now, who was behind? The idol. The boy is innocent. The idol took the money. So when you come here, please be patient. Whatever name doctor call your problem, be patient. Because I am convincingly convinced that the moment you cross this gate, enter the presence of God, your problem has found a solution. In the name of Jesus Christ. That's for the solution. So today, this is my advice to you. As we give our offering, we ask the Father, if he said we should lay hands, we lay hands. It was during the laying hands that he was picked. I didn't even know he was here. During the deliverance, I don't know him. I could not recognize him because I saw him last maybe about 10 years ago or how many years ago I saw him last. Much more than 10 years. 93, I saw you last. Can you hear that? I saw him last 1993. He called me on the phone. Hey, Alaji, I want to come to see you. But he never came. He never came. Oh, prophet, I want to come to see you. He doesn't know me as a prophet, though. He knows me as Alhaji. But he doesn't know. And what you don't know, you don't. No. And what you even think you know, you don't know. And because you don't know, you don't know. Hallelujah. But I want to tell you something today. No matter how many years they have caged you, you are out of cage. You are out of cage. He never fall down. He don't even know what happened. He refused to watch the video. He refused to watch it. He went to synagogue. He gave me the story. He went to synagogue. During the deliverance, the demon said, pack your bag and go. He ran away. He packed his bag and go. And that's what happened to most of you. That always say, I love that church. But the problem, they close late. Imagine, no food from morning till evening. Maybe the day the Lord will give us the grace, there will be some fruit. If there's no fruit, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Please be patient. Tell your neighbor, be patient. Amen. I know most people are still going now. They are going. They are tired. They want to go. Who is taking them out? You say so, not me. Shout hallelujah. But every demon that have been taking you away from the presence of God and make you to be suffering, looking for money here and there, crying every day, having sleepless night, that demon today is finished. Yeah. Today is finished. All your hanging blessings must locate you. Yeah. Just like this boy, Thursday was delivered. On Friday, He didn't tell you people that the guy wanted him to travel the same day. He wanted him to travel on Friday. He said, my business is finished in Ethiopia. They are stealing my money. Please go and represent me. He said, I'm a millionaire. I have so much. He asked him how much he want. He said, name your price. I will pay. This was someone that could not get 20 rand to come to church. Huh? That day they gave him money. He looked at the money. He said, oh, me? My money? That is a portion in the name of Jesus Christ. One more thing I want to tell you. Whenever you sit down here, continue to meditate. Continue to meditate in the word of God. Because you are sitting down here, the angels are busy solving your problems. That's why I always tell you, God's time is the best time. You that are sitting here, please, and please, I join you in the name of the living God. Be patient with my God. Amen. Be patient with your Father. Amen. And I know he will never disappoint you. Amen. Instead, he will appoint you. Amen. And when he appoints you, no one can disappoint you. Amen. When he qualifies you, no one can disqualify you. In the name of Jesus Christ, Amen. It is well with you.
Connect with God from wherever you are through Rapha TV channel. Connect with God from wherever you are through Rapha TV channel.